watching News 3, the Southern Illinois news leader. Live from WSIL-TV in high definition. News 3 starts right now.
Lawmakers look to reopen a former work camp. Plus, officials say you might have been the latest target of Facebook hoax. But first, Carterville authorities are trying to figure out what happened to a cannon in a community park. Good evening. Smoke covered a neighborhood this afternoon in Mount Vernon after a house caught fire. Take a look at this picture that was sent in by a viewer. An onlooker told us that the fire took place at 1501 South 12th Street and that multiple fire departments responded. A witness also says that the man living inside along with his pets were able to escape, but the homeowner was taken to the hospital for smoke inhalation. We will have more information on this fire as we receive it. And Carterville police need your help gathering information on damage in Cannon Memorial Park. Employees found the cannon pictured here damaged on Thursday. It appears the cannon was hit by a vehicle, but the surveillance video footage is inconclusive. So far, authorities don't have any suspects. If you have any information, call the Carterville PD at the number on the bottom of your screen. Police on both sides of the river are investigating a deadly shooting near Cape Girardeau this evening. Earlier today, Cape Girardeau Sergeant Rick Schmidt confirmed with us that around 4 a.m. this morning, an incident started on the Levee Road on the Illinois side of the Bill Emerson Memorial Bridge. Later on, that led police into the Missouri side of the bridge near Cape Girardeau. No word at this time if or are there any possible suspects. And we're going to turn it over to J.C. Brian, who has a first look at weather. J.C.
Well, weather-wise, we have seen a little shower activity throughout the day, generally staying focused off into southeastern Missouri. And now we've got a few tiny little showers making their way through western Kentucky. But for the most part, we're going to be staying dry this evening, along with partly cloudy skies. And as we all know, it was another very warm day, especially for October. Things have cooled down at least a little bit this evening. Right now in Elizabethtown, we're coming in at 71 degrees in McLeansboro, 78, Carbondale at 76, Mount Vernon 75, so certainly much more comfortable than earlier today. Unfortunately, tomorrow is looking like another hot day. We'll start off the day in the upper 60s by 11 a.m., already climbing back up into the 80s. And then again, as we push into the afternoon, climbing up into the upper 80s. Thankfully, we do have a big cool down on the way, along with some rain chances. I'll give you more details on that coming up in your forecast.
We'll see you soon, JC. One local restaurant celebrated a birthday this weekend, but the owner wasn't looking for gifts. Instead, in celebrating the Made Right in Christopher's 90th anniversary, the drive-in asked their customers to pay it forward. After Saturday's party, Made Right raised more than $1,200 and donated the money to Sarah Myers Keltner and her family. Sarah's a mom of three kids, and she's currently battling stage 4 colon cancer. The sandwich shop is located off North Victor Street in Christopher. Years after closing of Hardin County Work Camp, state lawmakers are working to reopen the facility. Governor Bruce Rauner and Illinois prison officials decided to close the camp in August of 2016. If it reopens, the new detention center will be able to house 75 to 100 inmates and employ almost 40 full-time workers. It will also be able to house federal inmates. Senator Fowler says the first step is to transfer the property from the Illinois Department of Corrections to Hardin County. Local leaders can then move forward after that. Coming up on News 3, 20 are dead after a limo crash in upstate New York. Plus, you might be the victim of the latest Facebook hoax. We'll be right back with that and more.